Merci. I belong to the OAIC, but people to action. I don't agree with those who are important portfolio that is given in Kenya. But I just want us to maybe to come up with an advocacy because of what is happening. There was a scenario case in Tanzania and Kenya. Yes, the caravan did very well. I was part of it. But what I'm asking is, now since when you say faith for life, it means that it is inclusive. And we see in Tanzania, those students, girls who give birth, they are not allowed to go back to school. It's the policy of the government, pronounced by the president. I don't know what faith leaders and other actors are doing so that those girls can enjoy the freedom of education. I don't know whether there's anybody from Tanzania who can tell us how that happened and when we have religious leaders there who can intervene, political leadership and other actors in the country. Then the second question. During the KCSE in Kenya, the first 2 days that 5 girls did their exam in maternity ward, that 5, in 2 days. And the exam will take about 14 days. So my question is, yes, what are we doing? What is our role? Are we really catering for those young girls? Or are we saying that they are not supposed to practice for running? Because that is happening and it has happened. The best part of it is that in Kenya, they can go back to school. But you see, when that 14, 15 years ago, they are giving back that 5 of them in 2 days, and there are many more, I would want us to see what we can do as religious leaders, faith community, as we all work together. In Kenya, we have what we call Interreligious Council of Kenya. And we have also DRIT, the Dialogue Reference Group.